Today we are sharing some parables with you. All these parables are about eternal values, love, trust, honesty, humanity. We invite you to listen, think, and participate.
It was snowing. This is common in winter. The weather was calm, and large fluffy snowflakes slowly circled in a bizarre dance, slowly approaching the ground. Two snowflakes flying nearby decided to start a conversation. They held hands, and one of them said cheerfully, "How good to fly! Enjoy the flight!" "We are not flying, we are just falling," the other answered sadly. "Soon we will meet the earth and turn into a white fluffy blanket." "No, we are going to die and they'll just trample us on the ground." "We will become streams and drown to the sea. We will live forever," said the first. "No, we will melt away and disappear forever," the other snowflake said. Finally, they got tired of arguing. They let go of each other's hands and each flew to the fate of her own choosing.
What is the moral of this parable?
The moral of the parable is to always think positively.
Once a professor of physics and mathematics, with the intention of teaching students a lesson that will be remembered for a lifetime, wrote a big number one on the blackboard. And having looked at the students, explained, "This is your humanity, the most essential quality in life." Then he wrote 0 next to the number 1 and said, "And each 0 is one of your achievements, which added to humanity, make you 10 times more precious." So he added 0 for experience, caution, good manners, love. Suddenly, he erased the number 1 at the beginning of a row of zeros, and meaningless zeros remained on the blackboard. The professor said, "If you don't have humanity, the rest is worthless." The parable is about always staying human.
One father had two sons with quite different characters. The time has come, they have matured and face a problem of choosing a profession. They came to father to consult. "Father, I want to get rich, but I'm greedy." "Conversely, you are economical." "I want to get rich too," the other son said, "but I like to spend money more than to save them." "You are just not attached to money. It means that you are free to invest the business." "I'm so important," the first said. "No, you are just punching." "I'm indecisive," the second said. "You are just thoroughly calculating the options." "I'm kind of nervous." "Conversely, you are very energetic. You have now here to put your energy here." "I'm lazy." "No, you just can't relax and distribute forces." "They said about me that I'm crazy," said the other. "No, you are only emotional. You don't hide your feelings. People like it. That's good." "And I'm reserved." "It's wonderful. Your intention will never be known to competitors. That's good for business." "I'm angry," the first son said. "You are not angry and demanding." "And I'm good-natured." "It means that people will help you with pleasure." "I'm too stubborn." "Excellent. You will persist in achieving your goal." "And I'm kind of absent-minded." "You are just creative." That's how being tolerant and persuasive, wise father made his two sons with different characters happy.
What is the moral of this parable?
The moral is wise, tolerant, and correct words may change the world.
Vasily asks at the master, "Why do you pay me 5 coins and Borisa 500 coins?" The master asks in response to Vasily, "Are they carrying hay in the distance by any chance?" "I don't know. then go and see. Vasily returns and says, Yes, hey, what meadow? I don't know. Then go and ask. The worker comes again and answers, From Konstantinovsky meadow. And what moving hay, the first or second? I don't know. Go and ask. Vasily returns again and says, The first moving, how much do they sell? I don't know. Ask, please, says the master. Once again, the employee comes and answers the question. 500 coins each. Are they bargaining? I don't know, Vasily says again. At this moment, Boris is entering and saying to the master, the day was brought from Konstantinovsky needle. It's the first moving. I asked how much, they said 500 coins each. I bargained with him to 300. Are we buying and unloading it? The master turns to Vasily and says, That's why I pay you 5 coins and Boris 500 coins.
And what is this parable about?
This parable about that it's important to take the initiative, ask, be interested, be active and positive.
A group of graduates of a prestigious university, successful, who have made a wonderful career, came to visit their old professor. During the conversation, the graduates complained of numerous difficulties and problems in life. Having offered to coffee the guests, the professor went to the kitchen. He returned with a pot of coffee and a tray with various cups, porcelain, glass, plastic, crystal. Some were cheap and simple, others expensive, sophisticated. When graders discerned cup, the professor said, Please note that all the beautiful cups were dismantled, while the simple and cheap ones remained. It's normal for you to want only the best for yourself, but this is the source of your problems and stress. Understand that a cup doesn't make coffee better. Most often, it's simply more expensive, but sometimes it even hides what we drink. In reality, all you wanted was just coffee, not a cup. Now think about it. Life is coffee, and war, money, position, and society are cups. These are just tools of maintaining life. What kind of cup we have does not determine or change the quality of our life. Sometimes, focusing only on the cup, we forgot to enjoy the taste of coffee itself.
What is this moral? What is the moral of this parable?
People should enjoy life itself, not the tools to maintain it.
We do hope you got now wisdom, tolerance and peace. Goodbye for now, and may all your dreams come true.